just looking inside the ribs of this martini base. That's the lower bout. You can see the end pin hole. But, I mean, other than just kind of, you know, all the water damage, so this is, you know, from dampets and stuff like that. But my point in showing this is not a lot of luthiers do external linings anymore. But one thing I would note, if you're doing external linings, make sure your internal linings are deeper than your external linings. What I see a lot of on these old bases when they're breaking, there's always cracks right along where the rib, where the two linings met. So the internal and external linings were both the same depth. See that there? And I think what happens is because it's so built up and the rib in the middle part of that is so flexible, it's like a natural shear point. So a lot of times I see these bases when the internal and external linings match in depth, they get a lot of cracking on the rib, and that's overlapped. Now I gotta take that all apart. But so if you're gonna do external linings, you know, keep them like this is nice. They're thin. They're almost more decorative. Internal linings, do them deeper. Don't match the same height. Hopefully that adds a little flexibility to the plate and helps keep the ribs from cracking from the wiggle point. When you're bending metal, you know, you can bend metal like a paperclip, bend it back and forth, back and forth, back and forth, back and forth, and the metal just fatigues, it stresses, and it cracks. I think the wood is the same way. You get all this flexibility up here where it's really, really thin. I mean, really thin. And then when you beef up that rim, and internal and external is pinching the wiggle point, it's cracking them. So anyways, just my two cents.